Hey there, it's Kaylee. Today, we're going to talk about something that I love, equations. This is a really exciting part of algebra and something you will continue to use in math. Ready? Let's go. To start, let's review what we know about algebra so far. We know that there are things called expressions. An easy one would be 3 + 4. We can evaluate expressions by order of operations. So in this case, all we have to do is add and we would get 7. And we know that expressions can have variables. What's a variable again? Yeah, it's a number that can vary, a number that can change. We represent this varying number as a symbol. Typically a lowercase letter like x. So we could have an expression with a variable that looks like 2x plus 1. And if we want to evaluate this expression, yeah, we need to know some given values for x. So what if we're told that x is equal to 2? We could evaluate this by using substitution. We plug in the given value of 2 wherever we see x, so we would get 2 times 2 plus 1. Order of operations, we multiply first, we get 4 plus 1, and that would give us 5. But what if we're told that x is equal to 6? Then to evaluate this expression here, we're going to use substitution again, so we'll have 2 times 6 plus 1. Using order of operations, we multiply first, we get 12 plus 1, and that would give us 13. Perfect. So we know all about expressions. That means it won't be too tricky when I tell you what an equation is. An equation is just one expression that is equal to or equates to, hence the name equation, another expression. For example, 2x plus 1 equals 7 is an equation. How come? Because we have an expression on one side, 2x plus 1, that's an expression, is equal to, that's what the equal sign means, another expression, 7. And yes, 7 by itself is an expression. We can have even more complex expressions too, like 2x plus y equals 5z. That's an equation because one expression is equal to another expression. So what are some equations you probably already know? Some super famous equations are the area of a rectangle. Do you remember it? It says A equals L times W, or area equals length times width. How about the circumference of a circle? That equation looks like C equals 2 pi r, which means circumference equals 2 times pi times the radius of the circle. See, that's awesome. You already know how to use equations. This isn't so complicated. Let's do a few examples together where we say if the statement is an equation or an expression. This one says 25 minus 4y. Is this an expression or an equation? What do you think? Well, I have an expression right here and that's it, right? No equal sign. So this one is an expression. Next one says 3x plus 2 equals 5. Expression or equation? Well, let's see here. I have an expression right here equal to another expression. Remember, a number by itself is an expression. So expression equal to expression, that means equation. Perfect. And let's do one more. Last one says x plus 2y minus z equals 0. Expression or equation? Whew, this one's tricky, right? What does this 0 here mean? Is that an expression? You know what? 0 by itself is an expression. So that means this equal sign right here That gives it away. This one is an equation. Now that you've been introduced to equations, you can do some practice identifying expressions and equations on your own. Have fun and remember to always be clever. Hey.